गुड मॉर्निंग स्टूडेंट. लास्ट क्लास वी स्टडीड अबाउट द कॉन्सेप्ट शॉर्ट रन, लॉन्ग रन, टोटल प्रोडक्ट, एवरेज प्रोडक्ट, मार्जिनल प्रोडक्ट. दिस एंड ऑल द कॉन्सेप्ट वी हैव स्टडीड. सो इन दैट द टोटल प्रोडक्ट इज रेफर्स टू द टोटल वॉल्यूम ऑफ द गुड्स एंड सर्विसेज दैट कैन बी प्रोड्यूस इन अ पर्टिकुलर टाइम पीरियड. सो टोटल प्रोडक्ट वी विल मेंशन इट एज अ टीपी, विच मीन्स टोटल प्रोडक्ट. इट इज राइज, द टोटल प्रोडक्ट इंक्रीजेस व्हेन द क्वांटिटी ऑफ द वेरिएबल इंक्रीजेस. इफ देर इज इंक्रीज इन द लेबर, इफ देर इज अ इंक्रीज इन द कैपिटल, द टोटल प्रोडक्ट ऑटोमेटिकली गोज इंक्रीजिंग. When it come to average product, we symbolize average product as a AP. Average product is nothing but we will divide it by the total product. So the formula for the average product is TPL divided by L, that is labor. So average product is defined as the output per unit of the variable input. So last comes for the marginal product. So how we will calculate marginal product? MPL is equal to change in output divided by change in input. So that comes delta TP divided by delta L. That is about the marginal product. And we studied about the production function. When it come to production function, there are two kinds of variable, that is input and output, and other the factors are there, which is variable and fixed factors, variable factors and the fixed factor. So when it come to input, so input means the land, labor, capital, enterprises or entrepreneurship or organization, we will call them as a input. When it come to output means by using this input you are going to produce some commodity, that may be cars, house, food, computers or daily required items, electronic gadget, that you are going to produce. So input means which and all the things you are going to use to produce the output. Next, I said there are two types of factors, that is fixed input and variable input, or fixed factor and variable factor. What do you mean by fixed input or fixed factor? The quantity of which remains the same irrespective of the level of output produced by a firm. For example, land, building, machine. So these are going to be fixed. If you buy one machine, that is fixed for another 5 years, 10 years. If you bring a laptop for work, that is fixed for another 3 to 5 years. Or the building, land, it is going to be fixed. Variable means which is goes on changing. The quantity of which varies the level of output produced by a firm. For example, raw material, power, fuel, transport facility, labors, etc. This we will call as a variable factors. So I hope you are clear with the concept of the fixed factor and the variable factor and input and output. So next we are going to study about the law of variable proportion. So law of variable proportion, it will explain about the production process. It is completely related to production. So production, when it related, it will explain in its theory how total product, average product and marginal product are connected with each other and how does it affect to the production. And law of variable proportion, it also explain the total product, average product and marginal product with the help of graph and chart. So law of variable proportion you can study with the help of chart and graph. That also you can study under law of variable proportion. So when it comes to law of variable proportion, keeping other factor fixed, the law explains that production function with one factor variable. So one factor variable means it is taking only one factor. So there are two factors always we will study, that is labor and capital. Here it is using only one factor. Which factor? That is variable, means which is goes on changing. Among capital and labor, which one is a variable factor? Whether capital is a variable factor? No, capital is a fixed factor. When it comes to labor, it is a variable factor. So in under the law of variable proportion, we are going to study by taking labor. Only one factor we are taking, that is labor. So another name for law of variable proportion, we will call it also the law of diminishing marginal product. So we will call it as in another name, law of diminishing okay. So we were talking about the factor. So here we are taking only one factor, that is labor, which is variable in nature, which is goes on changing, which is not a fixed factor. In the short run, when the output of a commodity is okay, when it comes to short run, the output of a commodity is sought to be increased. So when it comes to short run, the output will be increasing format. So if you studied about the last table where we calculated total product, marginal product and average product, if you see in the starting, it is increasing. The marginal product first it will be 10, next it is going to be 14, next it is going to be 16. So it always it will be increasing, because when you bring new machinery or when you hire a new person, the energy of working is higher, or the machine will work in more efficiently. As the year passes, the efficiency of machine reduces. If you see the laptop, computers or the phone gadgets, when you bring a new phone, it will work faster. After years, it start to decline its efficiency. So it is increasing. The law of variable proportion come into operation. So it will come in the short run where we are taking only one factor, that is labor, which is variable in the nature. So if you see the last table, there we have taken only one factor, that is labor. With the help of labor, we calculated the marginal product and the average product. So therefore, when the number of one factor is increased or decreased while other factors are constant, the portion between the factor is altered. So therefore, when one number of factor is increasing or reducing, when the labor increases or reduces, and while other factor are constant, which other factor we are keeping here as a constant? Capital or the land we are keeping here as a constant. There are no changes in the capital, only changes will be there in the labor. The proportion between the factors is altered. That means it goes on changing. It will be not constant, because there is one variable factor and one constant factor. Here we are not considering capital. Why? It is constant. That's why we are not considering. And we are considering only a labor. For instance, there are two factors of the production, which is land and labor. We are not considering here land, or we will call it as a capital. Here we are not taking that factor. Here we are taking only one factor, that is labor. So I hope you understood with the concept. If you have any doubt, you can clarify with me. So law of diminishing marginal utility, next class you are going to study with the graph and table. So it explains only about the relationship between total product, marginal product and average product by taking one factor, that is labor, which is variable in nature. Simple. One factor, labor we are taking, and we are going to study the relationship between total product, marginal product and average product. Thank you, student.